Today I'm going to be taking some boring or basic outfit pieces and I'm going to transform them into three amazing outfits. Each one has its own flair too. So they are ones that don't really have a lot of color or anything going on to them. So it's really going to be based on building pieces that are classic in their cut and just pairing them together to really make something more fascinating. I will link everything down below or at least similar items, but I do think that each one of these pieces you might find hanging up in your wardrobe already. Speaking of closets, I will be creating a closet sale very soon in the next few weeks or so, and I wanted a way, since they sell out really quickly, for you guys to be able to find out a little bit prior to when I post. So if you sign up for my emails down in the description below, I will be able to give you guys at least an hour of prior notice to my closet sale, so you will be able to snatch up pieces quicker, and it should be a bigger sale too because I haven't done a closet sale in like a year and a half. For this first outfit, I'm just pairing a basic white tee with my favorite pair of jeans. So this is a very classic pair of jeans, nothing big going on here. There's very little whiskering, and I feel like that's important when shopping if you want something that doesn't emphasize the width of your hips. That's something that I would like to de-emphasize. So I've got something that fits with my proportions well. Overall, when this first begins, this outfit is not amazing, but these pieces will start to transform as they go along. So the first thing that I wanna do is to tuck in my top, and that's just going to de-emphasize the length of the top, and then it's going to emphasize how long that line is from the top of my jeans all the way down to my feet. So they are still buckling at the bottom, and so I'm going to add some higher shoes there. So I'm going with this ankle boot. This is a very classic one that I wear frequently and just something that gives a little bit of a heel. And because it's this skin tone color, I feel very comfortable wearing this in summertime. And it also gives the illusion that I've just got, you know, basically bare feet there. This also could work if you just wanted to have a heel instead, something strappier, easier to breathe. That could definitely work as well. So one train of thought when it comes to dressing as a petite is to create that long illusion of this long pair of pants. So with jeans, I think that there's one more thing that I can do, which is I can make a cropped look. So instead of cropping them, instead of rolling them several times, I'm going to bring a giant chunk of my jeans up. And that's going to show and elevate the look of my heels. It's gonna look like I'm on stilts. And so this is just one ironic way that I can do this look. And I think that it gives this whole outfit a different vibe. One thing about jewelry that I like to do if the outfit is extra casual is then add a watch. And the watch is going to make this outfit look a lot smarter while still being casual. I would not add a watch if the outfit was extremely formal, but I would definitely add it to an outfit that's dressed down. If you feel daring enough to wear a hat, it does feel a little bit weird at first if you're new to it, but I love it because whenever I wear this, I feel like it's got that effortlessly cool factor to it. It's also going to be a great alternative to just wearing shades. I love wearing a hat because it's going to keep all that sun out of my face, out of my eyes, and it's adding so much self-expression and style to the outfit. It will give that look of this mysterious who is she factor. I like this beige one that I've been wearing since last year, and it carries well into fall. So you can wear a hat like this between, you know, the beginning of summer into late fall, and it works very well. But one thing to know is if you do wear a hat like this, everyone will have your attention when you walk into a room. So just know that and own it. Okay, so why I think this outfit is pulling together well with this hat is that it creates this Nashville edgy look, sure, but it also is going to add that third piece that a lot of different fashion bloggers talk about all the time, right? So whenever you've got one piece, two piece, and that magic third piece, no matter what it is for the season, in this case, it's my hat, and that's going to add my fashion, my sense of self-expression to the outfit, and I would dare say that it actually adds a little bit of literal height to the outfit because it's making me just that much taller. My bag choice for this outfit is going to be this Polen bag. It's going to carry through a lot of those brown accents throughout the outfit. It's not going to overwhelm. And also it's got a little bit of that Western vibe to it as well. So I've got that in my heels, I've got that in my hat, and now I've got it on my bag. And one thing that I always like to do with my bags is to add a little bit more femininity through adding a scarf there. This is also going to add a pattern to an outfit that otherwise is boring. So you can still cut back on your color choices and all of your patterns, and you can just add something simple like this. And lastly, what I like to do with this outfit is to have a little cardigan. As I've said in other videos, I feel so super cold when I walk into an air-conditioned building. And it can be 95 degrees outside, ridiculous to wear a cardigan at, but then it's so freezing cold inside. So I like to add a little bit something here. The way that I'm styling this outfit today is a little bit off the shoulder. So of course you can wear it like a regular cardigan if you feel comfortable that way, but having it off the shoulder is going to just make you a little bit more chill, laid back, also just adds a little bit of texture to an outfit that otherwise isn't. My next look is much more comfortable and it's more on the athleisure side. So I find a lot of inspiration when it comes to athleisure from like Hailey Bieber. I think that she does a really excellent job at this. And so the basic thing that I want to do is have a really comfortable sort of cropped up top. This is going to have a little bit of this V-neck, but it's almost a scoop neck look to it. And so because it is very cropped up, I'm going to have some pants that are wide-legged, they're very high-waisted, and they are very comfortable. So these normal Kamali pants are going to add a lot of length. Right now they look kind of crazy because I don't have any shoes on with the outfit, but they are extremely comfortable, and if you're traveling in them, they're great because they don't wrinkle at all, and they are definitely buckling right now, so let's change that. When picking out the shoes that I wanted to wear for this outfit, I ended up going with my espadrilles because when I have those pants covering up my heels or my shoes a lot, this is going to almost look like a sneaker, but it's going to elevate much more than a regular sneaker would. These are some of my tallest shoes, so they work very well with these very long pants. They're going to just drape and they shouldn't drag the ground very much, and that's the key. My hat choice for this outfit is going to be a baseball cap. Because this is much more of an athleisure look, it works very well, but I like to add a baseball cap to just any outfit and see where it takes the style. A lot of times it can create an entirely different look. What's cool about what's happening in this outfit is that the pants are formal and the shoes, I would say, are formal as well. But the top two pieces, they're more sporty, and it creates this illusion of what I remember from when I played tennis, where it's like the one sport you can wear and still wear a skirt. So it has this sort of sporty look, but it's also formal, and I like to be able to blend those two looks a lot. So this is going to create a very chic outfit from the start with these combinations, but I want to do a couple more things to it. Of course, I'm going to accessorize, and so I'm going to add some necklaces that are going to emphasize that V shape on the neckline, and that's going to help a lot. Adding a little gold bracelet is going to make it more on that sort of tennis inspiration as well, and I just sort of look to elements like that, lifestyles like that, that I remember and appreciate, and they help me create these looks to be more on theme to something else that might be familiar. One of my top tips is to invest in jewelry. If you were to only add a few pieces of heirloom quality jewelry to even the most basic outfit, that will look like an expensive outfit. So I would say if you want to go the furthest with how you invest in your wardrobe, I would not overlook jewelry at all. For my bag choice with this outfit, this is my other Polen bag. This is basically the same bag, but it's in black. And it's going to add some of those more geometric shapes to this outfit. And I feel like it complements the outfit very well. It's got a lot of those triangular shapes that are happening with the V-neck. And it also looks sporty and it's going to match the gold jewelry. My final outfit is something more feminine. And one thing that you guys have been asking for a lot is for outfits that have skirts or dresses in them. And frankly, since I've been at home more, I haven't found many outfits that I want to wear with a skirt. I don't enjoy wearing skirts just when I'm lounging around the house, but I did want to put one together for you guys. So I'm going to start with a very basic white cami. This should be something that everyone has in their wardrobe or has had at some point. It is more dressed down, so wearing it with a more feminine skirt is going to do wonders. This is an old one that I have that I've just kept forever. It's linen, it's a wrap skirt, and wrap skirts and dresses are universally flattering. They also expose a little bit of leg, and they just slim the leg down too, so it's just this beautiful elongating look. To add some instant height to this outfit and to elongate my legs even more, I'm adding these shoes again. So these are my espadrilles, and also having this straw, like this braided straw around them. At any angle with this outfit, it looks summery and beautiful. I would say too that it's better not to have ankle straps if you want to look taller, but I'm really taking the hit here because these are my tallest shoes. And I think that with this outfit, it just looks so feminine and it's monochrome. Next, I am going to add my jewelry again, and this is going to work more with more casual pieces than anything else. So this cami is very basic, and I would say that camis have a tendency to look a little bit cheap. So I would definitely accessorize whenever you wear a cami. But then I want to add a little bit more intrigue to this outfit. So I'm adding one of my cardigans again. This is going to keep me warm in those environments. It's also cropped up, which is so important when this is a skirt that hits me right at my smallest point on my waist. That's going to lengthen the skirt so much more than if this was draped, you know, halfway down my hip. That would not be the same look at all. So having a cropped cardigan is very important. And because I have more contrasting features, having a contrasting outfit is going to work in my favor. So sort of assess that about yourself and see if this outfit might work better for you by having something that's less contrasting. And lastly, the bag that I went with is one of my old standbys. I love my Chloe Test bag. I like the way that this is something that's round. So when you're working with a limited color palette and basic pieces, it's really important to focus in on how you want shapes to work toward your advantage. So the past couple of bags have been more rectangular or triangular, and having something that's round here is going to be more feminine for this very feminine outfit. And also an old trick that my friend from high school taught me is to be able to add repetition to the colors that you're wearing. So I'm not just isolating that black cardigan by itself. I'm inviting that color to the party here by adding the same color to my bag. So that's just one more technique that you can use when you're trying to add interest to an outfit that basically has very neutral or boring pieces to them. So those were my three looks. I do plan to wear a feminine outfit, an athleisure outfit, and an edgy outfit at any point during this summer. And so having these different looks all still express me and different versions of me through my outfits. But don't forget to sign up for those notifications as far as closet sales down in the description below where you can find that. And other than that, guys, I guess I will see you next time. I'm hoping to post once a week. And so I'm just really making it my prerogative to be able to be more consistent and to post more regularly. And so yeah, I will see you guys next week. Bye.